in their own languages. These are to us seems insufficient what we are obtaining from our cellular phone services. So we built long ago, about four, five, six years ago, we built our own wireless network, about 130 kilometers. We established several centers focusing the local needs, like one with some agricultural area. It was an agricultural area. We tried to establish some kayaks over there so that farmers could come and ask for their pesticides or what's the price of the commodity, something like that. We also established one in the fisheries area in the southern part of our country. They produce shrimps, shrimp culture, so they need those kind of connectivity to make connection with the, I mean, communication with the external world. We established a perhaps that was the unique one, a cyclone shelter based information center, just on a cyclone shelter. It was running very nicely. And we also introduced a school program. We could distribute about 500 computers to very remote areas. We did provided some training to the teachers, not to the students, as it also it has been mentioned here. But we faced several problems, like what it came here also. We needed a self-sustaining business model that we are now facing, because some of them has been phased out in the locality. They couldn't afford. They couldn't, because those people are very poor, the poverty-driven area, especially the poverty-driven area, because they needed those things. So it's nice that the things came out, that it's good to be something good to be running for a long, rather than something just came up and vanish away. That's bad for a society. Two thing we learned from this, it also has been raised here. Two of our regional node has been successful, because maybe a question will come, who paid for us? UNDP, it was a UNDP project till December 2006, but we could adopt some self-sustaining business model in two of the regional area. We connected one college, education institute, and one university, agriculture university. So they could pay for our bandwidth and we could provide the services over the local community. So two of the regional centers are self-sustaining. They are running very nicely. One of them is including the cyclone shelter and a college, and one in the poverty-driven area. We did a lot of MDG-related survey over there, and the largest agriculture university in Bangladesh is connected with us. So they are providing our subsidy, something like that. Now I will talk about some challenges that we are facing related to internet governance. Licensing is a very big problem in our country. Licensing, government is a little bit reluctant to issue licenses to operate those telecenters. You need a localized license or a national license or a nationwide ISP. We are debating over with the government about it, and it's been carrying out for long, for the last 3, 4, 5 years. It's very recently it has been raised more. So whatever, you need a district license or a national license, something like that. So it's an issue. And of course, related to VoIP, we are in problem. VoIP is not legalized in our country. So people are looking forward to it. The grassroots level are looking forward to it. Very recently they have legalized, but somehow we think that that has been marginalized. They said that they just pick a number. Unfortunately, that is a 3. You need only 3 VoIP gateway in a country. So we said, what's the magical significance of the 3? Anyway, I'm not talking about the government thing, but we are in communication with them, so that hopefully it will be reluctant, and hopefully will be. And the services we have been providing over there, I have told you that we did a lot of things in our local language, providing market prices, a list of vendors producing things like rice, paddy, or those things, a list of physicians available locally, a list of healthcare centers who can give you some primary care healthcare services, and a list of emergency services like that. And we are waiting for some thrust over there, so that all those schools, though we have distributed about, as I told you, about 500 computers over 200 schools, one computer or two computers or three computers per school, depending on the locality, depending on their ability. Though they don't have enough electricity to run those computers, but whenever the electricity is available, they are running it. I have been physically over there. I have seen people, students especially, using them. But what we are waiting for, to make those schools as really a community center, so that after the, we have done one or two or three, but none, most of them are not connected, they are disconnected because of the infrastructure, you know. We are trying to connect them and trying to provide, trying to establish a common syllabus for especially grade 9 and 10, so that they can learn a common education, they can put in a common education platform. And more capacity building for the teachers and especially for the student frequent basis that we have been waiting for. Hopefully 2008 year will be good for us, because IGF is going to in India, and for South Asian people we are looking forward to more benefits.